Welcome to the Excel Chapter 3 exam review. I'm in my T-Lab and I want to go to Excel Chapter 3 exam review. That link, I want to go to download files. And all we need on here is one start file. Notice we've got instructions and then final results. I'm going to open the instructions so that I'll have them on my screen for you. And I'm going to open the start file. I use Mozilla Firefox. It makes it easy just to click open or save. Be sure to enable editing on your start file. I'm going to snap that to the left. Snap it to the left. And I'm going to snap my instructions to the right. I have two monitors, so sometimes I have trouble snapping. So I'm just going to downsize it and place it right here. The first thing they want us to do is save the document. So let's do File, Save As. I'm going to my computer, and I have my folder on my desktop. So I want to scroll to my desktop, my IT1010. My Excel and my Excel Chapter 3. They want us to name the file our last name, first name, EXL03_SA1 center. That's number one done. We're going to number two. Number two would like us to group the worksheets. When you group the worksheets, it allows you to do whatever you do to one worksheet. Also does it to all of the worksheets. So to group, you want to go down here and right click. I'm going to right click on first quarter and choose select all sheets. Notice my tabs became dim down here, and at the top you will see group by your file name in the title bar. That way you know you're grouped. So I've grouped the worksheets and they want us to do a formula in E5. The formula, they want us to compute the net income minus compute net income, and that would be your income minus both indirect and direct costs. So we're going to type equals to start a formula. We're going to take our income. I'm going to click on B5 minus, and then we're going to add our indirect and direct within parentheses. So we're going to do left parentheses C5 plus D5 right parentheses. And you should get 4140 if you're on the first quarter tab. Notice I'm on the first quarter. Now we want to fill that down. We're going to use our autofill button. We're going to point to the little green square at the bottom right of the active cell and scroll down until you see your skinny black plus sign. So now I have filled the formula down. We're going to select B5 through H5. B5 through E5, hold down control and select B8 through E8. We are going to make those a cell style, so go to your cell styles, and it is in the number format group way at the bottom, fourth column over, currency with the zero in brackets. That was number three. I'm going to number four. We want a new worksheet, so we're going to go to the bottom where our worksheets are and click the plus sign. And we're going to name that summary. So I'm going to double click on sheet one and type summary with a capital S. Make sure you hit enter so that it accepts the name summary, because the next thing they want us to do is make it a tab color. So we're going to right click on the word summary, choose tab color, and they want this brown accent 5. It is the next to the last column, the first row. And people get bugged, they don't think it worked, but if you click over here on second quarter, you'll see that summary did turn brown. It is not full color when you're on that tab. So we want to make the summary tab our first tab, so we're going to point to summary and drag it so that it comes right before first quarter. And it is our first tab. Next, they want us to copy from one of the worksheets to the summary. So we're going to click on first quarter, select A1 through F4. excuse me, A1 through E4. A1 through E4. Control C is copy. Go to your summary tab. Do not just paste. You want to click on your paste options arrow up here by the clipboard. And we want to keep our source column widths and the formatting. So we want to go to the second row, second column paste option. And that's what you should look like. We want to click into A2 and type City Center Annual Revenue. Click in A4 and type quarter. Moving on to number 6, I'm going to type first quarter in A5. And I don't have to type second quarter, third quarter, fourth quarter. You want to go to your first quarter cell, A5, and use your fill button. Point to the little green square in the bottom right of the active cell until you see a skinny black plus sign and drag down. And you get second, third, and fourth quarter automatically. That is called the fill button. And A9, we're going to type total. And we just finished number 6. Click in B5. They want to see the total of the income from the first quarter worksheet. And that total happens to be in B8 over on the first quarter worksheet. So in order, we're going to tell the computer, type equals, the equal sign. Go to the first quarter tab. Click on the B8 cell. And just hit enter. And that appears on our summary worksheet. We're going to do that for the second, the third, and the fourth quarter. So in B6, we're going to type equals, go to the second quarter, click in B8, make it active, and hit enter. Third quarter, we're going to type equals, go to the third quarter, make B8 active, and hit enter. Fourth quarter, you want to type equals, go to the fourth quarter tab, make B8 active, and hit enter. Now we have brought all of our totals from each worksheet to our summary. Select B5 through B8. Instead of using the auto sum, which you're used to, they want to show you this quick analysis lens. So we're going to go to this icon. It's called the quick analysis. And click on totals. Notice all the things you can do with this new lens button. Click on the totals in the center, and then click on sum on the left. And that just is a different way to get our columns summed. We want to take A5 through A9. We want to fill that, so we're going to autofill that through column E. So let's point to our little fill button down here at the bottom of all the cells that are selected till you see a skinny black plus sign, and drag over through column E. And we have done our autofill. Row 9, just the numbers, select B9 through E9. Go to your cell styles. I'm going to have to map. Oh, no, they're right here. Cell styles. And make them the total cell style. It's the last column in the middle. And I usually click away to make sure it happened. It should have a line at the top and a double line at the bottom. Okay, we're going to group the sheets again. Right click on any one of the sheets and select all sheets. And we want to do a footer. So we're going to go to insert, text, and click on the header footer button. Sometimes you just see the header footer. I have to click on text to get to mine. It's the text group. Click on header footer. Now it brings us to the header in the center, and we want a footer. So at the top, you'll see go to footer up here in the center. And then you want to get in your left section of the footer instead of the center. So I'm in the left section, and I want the file name. So up here in my header footer elements, I click on the file name icon. And then I go into the right section, and in the header and footer elements, I click on sheet name. It won't show you the sheet name until you get out of that section. So I'm going to click right above it up here in the D cell. And notice it showed up first quarter. And now I want to go to normal view. So I'm going to go down here on my status bar and this grid icon down here that says normal. Click on normal. And do control home so you can get to the top of your paper worksheet. So we have finished up through number 10. We are on number 11. Be sure that your sheets are still grouped. I'm checking mine at the top here. It does say group. And they want us to check spelling. So we're going to go to the review tab and click on spelling. And make sure you're good to go. The last thing we're going to do is insert a clustered bar chart. So we're going to take that from the data on the summary chart. Summary worksheet. So click on summary and select the range A4 through A8. A4 through A8. Hold down control and leave it held down and select C4 through D8. C4 through D8. That shows us our indirect and our direct cost for each quarter. Go to insert, and the bar chart is the one that goes horizontal next to the column chart. Click on the first bar chart. They want it to be on its own sheet, so we're going to click on move chart up here in the location group of the chart tools design tab. Then you want to click on new sheet and type the new title. Center cost. You should now have a nice bar chart all by itself on its own sheet. We want style 9. Our chart styles are right up here in the middle of the ribbon. Click on it and get to style 10. Style 10. And then click on the chart title and replace chart title with city center. And we have finished. I'm going to make sure your chart's first, summary second, and then your four quarters. I'm going to close my document and save the changes. And I